Have a lovely morning to everyone. My dear students, how are you all? I hope all of you are fine and taking care of yourself with your family. In the previous class, we had learned about the games and sports, how they are useful for us. Today, we will learn new topic. The new topic is types of games. Types of games. So how many types of games? Let's see. Page number 21. Two types of games. So how many types of games? Two types of games. Games are of two types: indoor games and outdoor games. First of all, we will talk about outdoor games. Where we play outdoor games? What is outdoor games? Let's see. Games that are played in an open area like park, playground, ground and stadium are called outdoor games. So, what is outdoor games? Games that are played in open area. Open area means where the lot of space. Outdoor games need a lot of space. That's why we played in open area. We play in park, we play in ground, we play in a stadium. So, what is outdoor games? Games that are played in open area like park, playground, ground and stadiums are called outdoor games. And did you know the benefits of outdoor games? Okay, I will tell you the benefits of outdoor games. When you play outside of your house, your vitamin D level increased because there are lot of sunshine. So you play outside of game for increasing your vitamin D level. Your stress is reduced and your mood is fresh. And most important thing is concentration. When you play outdoor games, your concentration improve because you are work in team. You learn to cooperate with others. So, this is the benefits of outdoor games. And your pain decrease and healing improves when you play outdoor games. Outdoor exercise is good for mind and body. So, try to get outside for at least 30 minutes a day. Outdoor games help you body stay fit and strong. So, you can at least 30 minutes in every day regularly you get outside for 30 minutes every day regularly. So that's are the benefits of outside games. And there can be two types of outdoor games. First is individual games, where is no team. Two or four players only. That's why we are called individual outdoor games. And second is group outdoor games, team outdoor games, where two teams are available. 5, 7 or 9 players, 11 players in one team. And second team also have a 5, 9, 7, 11 member in one team. So that's why they are called the team outdoor games. Let's see. Games like badminton, tennis and golf are individual outdoor games. So badminton, tennis and golf are individual outdoor games because in these games one member in one team, and second team have also one member. That's why we called individual outdoor games. Games like badminton, tennis and golf are individual outdoor games. Many outdoor games are team sports. So many outdoor games are team sports like cricket, basketball, volleyball. There are two teams and so many members, so many players in one team. That's why we call the team sports. The founder of modern Olympic, Pierre de Coubertin, said, "The most important thing is not winning but taking part." So this is the very understandable line. The most important thing is not winning but taking part. So you are taking part in any competition, any event. This is the most important. If you win your program, this is very nice. But you are taking part in event. So you learn lot of things when you are work in team. So this is the most important thing. You are taking part in any event, any program. Okay, so always you take part when competition or events are going on your school, your college, your schools. So you always take part. Okay, next please. A team sport is played with the team spirit. The aim of victory in a team sport is for the team, not for a single player. Cricket, football and hockey are examples of team sports. You can see in this picture, this is the picture of football, this is the picture of hockey and this is the picture of cricket. There are two teams and there are so many players in one team. So when we play team sports, so the aim of victory in a team, not a single player, not for you. So you all play for team victory. You all play for the team, not for a single player, not for yourself. So this is the team sports or group sports. Second is indoor games. Games that are played indoors are called indoor games. So when we play in your house, that are called indoor games. We play some games in house, so that are indoor games. Games that are played indoors are called indoor games. People play indoor games mostly for recreation. Playing cards, carom, billiards and table tennis are popular indoor games. Some indoor games like chess are played as international level tournament. So you can see chess, Scrabble, Ludo, snake and ladders, billiards, table tennis. These games are indoor games. We play in our house. That's why we called indoor games. These are indoor games. So that's all for today's class. Today we learn about the indoor games and outdoor games. So revised it, and that's all for today's class. Thank you and take care.